Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lenny. Have you ever wondered how those smooth professional looking dance tutorial videos are made without hiring a camera crew, choreographer, or even an editor? In this video, I'll show you exactly how to create stunning AI powered dance tutorials from scratch. So whether it's salsa, Afrobeat, is and generate holistic dance videos using AI tools like Geo3 that handle the choreography, animation, voice, and even music. And in this tutorial, I'm going to walk you through the step-by-step process in Geo3 from writing the script, planning the moves to generating the videos. I'm going to show you the exact prompts I'm using to generate the AI videos, the background music, all with zero filming and dancing required. So whether you're a dance teacher, you're a content creator, or you're just curious about AI choreography, stick around and let's build your first AI dance video tutorial start to finish in Geo 3. Let's get started. Okay, so first things first, we want to first generate the image of our dance character. And for this tutorial, I'm going for like a male vibrant Afrobeat dancer. So I'm going to be using this exact prompt. I'll first come into lax.google/fx/tools. I'm going to leave the link to this in the description box. Also, we're on the screen for easy navigation. I'm going to come in here and I'll click on MusicFX. And when I click on MusicFX, I'm going to enter this exact prompt. And like I mentioned, because I'm going for like a vibrant Afrobeat dancer, I'm going for this exact prompt. And to be honest, like, you can really be as specific as possible. You can talk about how they look, their attire, their poses, and even the scene or the background. You can be as specific as possible. And then in terms of the aspect ratio, I'm going for 9:16 because I want to post this as a YouTube short. It really depends on what you want your aspect ratio to be. Have decided to use this as my aspect ratio. And yeah, at this point, all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna click on create and let's see what we get as an output. Okay, so this is really cool. I have about 4 different images that have been generated for me, so I'm just gonna download all these images onto my computer. So now that I have the images generated for me, the next step for me is to generate the music, okay? So again, I will come in here and I'm just gonna go into MusicFX. And in MusicFX, I'm just gonna enter this exact prompt to sort of build the type of music I want. And I'm going for some sort of music bar like you can really dance with. And in the prompt, I'm sort of also defining like the exact tempo. You can be as specific as that, especially if you're a dance teacher and you know exactly what a rhythm should be, what a tempo should be. Like I'm sort of like capturing all of them and in this particular prompt as well. So all these things are things you can customize. Then I'm gonna click on generate. The music has been created for us, which I like, so I'm just gonna click on download. Okay, so we have our image generated, our music generated. The next step is to generate a dance move. So I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna click on new project and I'm gonna go for frames to video. The reason why I'm going for frames to video is because I wanna like generate multiple scenes of dancing because I have like different prompts. And again, going back to this, like the prompts are sort of created in such a way that like it's sort of giving step-by-step instructions on how you can sort of perform or dance along with a dancer, which is why I'm doing like frames to video because I'm gonna have like multiple dance moves for every frame. So I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna click on this plus sign and I'm gonna click on upload, okay? If I didn't generate the image in the previous step, I could have also clicked on generate and I'll be able to like generate the image in here. But because I already like generated the image in the previous step, all I'm gonna do is upload the exact image I want. So this is the image of the dancer. So now that I have the image in here, all I'm gonna do is I'll crop and save. And in here, once this image is uploaded, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change this because I'm using Geo 3 and I'm gonna come in here and in the exact prompt, I'm gonna choose the exact prompt I want. So like I mentioned, I'm going for like a more Afrobeat dance style. So my first prompt would be this one. So I'm gonna be using this exact prompt for his first dance move. And it's sort of like giving the exact dance moves I need. And like I mentioned, these are things you could also customize as well. So I'm gonna click on enter. Remember, I'm using Geo 3. You're gonna have 2 different variations of the dancer's move and then we continue building on from there. Okay, so we have our first video ready for us. I'm gonna okay this. Okay, this is good. Now I'm gonna play this one as well. Oh, I like the fact that it's already generating the moves for you. It's already generating the background music as well. So that's really good. Okay, so I like this one better. So I'm just gonna download this. I've upscaled it. But yeah, so this is already upscaled now, so I'm gonna download it. But one thing that's so beautiful about using Veo 3 is the fact that you can click on add to scene, and really all you can do is you can sort of extend the scene. Okay, so if I click on plus and I just click on expand, it would allow me to continue with like a prompt. Okay, so that's one beauty about using Veo 3. So I'm gonna come in here and I enter the exact prompt I want, and like I mentioned, this is like giving instructions on like what exactly the dancer is gonna be doing. So he steps side to side, right and left, while isolating his upper body, and it talks about like exactly what the dancer is going to be doing next. So I'm gonna click on enter and let's see what we get. So it's complaining to switch, so I'm gonna click on this. I guess that second seam has been generated. You can also do a bit of like trimming or alignment. So that's what I just did, and I'm gonna play this now. So let me drag this to the beginning and let me play this now. And then I'm gonna do the mix twine. So again, I'm gonna click on mix scene. I'm gonna click on extend. I really want it to be extended at the end, so I'm gonna drag this to the end and I'm gonna click on extend. And then in the next prompt, I'm going to enter the exact dance move I want the dancer to do. This was the output of our cut scene. I'm going to play it for you. And then I'm going to add the prompt for the next scene. So the next scene, we're going to add a prompt for that. I'm not expecting any text on top of it, so I'm just going to take this out. And I'll click on enter. Yeah, so our scene is ready. I'm going to play the output. Okay, so that is good. I have like the last scene, which I'm gonna also include in the prompt. So I'm gonna be that as well. I'm gonna highlight this, click on this one, extend, and then I'm gonna add in the prompt. Then I'm gonna click on enter. Okay, so now I'm gonna like adjust this a bit. We have all our videos ready now. I'm gonna play the last spooks. Okay, so this is ready and all done for us. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna download all these onto my computer. The next step for me is to put all of them together, and to do so you can use CapCut, or you can use any video editing tool you have. Okay, so in this tutorial me learn CapCut. In CapCut, I'm just gonna be putting all these videos together, and if I'm adding some transitions. The other good thing is when using Veo 3, as you notice, some of the videos came with your own beat to match with the dance, so you can decide to keep it like that, or you could also include your own music in here, the music that was generated in the video instead. So I'm gonna mute the audio on here. You could also add in some transitions. So for instance, I could add in some transitions if I want, and then now I'm gonna play the entire video. Okay, so that is it for today's tutorial. I already have another AI bands video tutorial I did in the past. I'm gonna link that as well. Plenty for watching, and see you in the next one.